Hello, friends. Do you know heart diseases, which are number one in fatality all over the world, can be reversed and can be prevented without any invasive procedures like angiography, angioplasty, or coronary bypass surgeries or lifelong medications? Yeah, the good news is okay, all these problems, which is like the prevalent in the modern day society, can be reversed by simply certain modifications in our lifestyle and our dietary modifications. So, what is heart disease actually? Heart disease is our heart, before it supplies blood to the each and every part of our body or system, it gives supply to its own self through three coronary arteries. And when the blockages occur in these three coronary arteries, various heart issues result. 98% of the heart ailments are due to these blockages. And what are these blockages? Blockages is a accumulation of sticky, greasy substance we are taking through food into the inner layer of the arteries, which is the endothelium layer, and the sticky deposits over the ears get deposited on that, and this gradually builds up the plaque and the blockages begin. So the two major culprits which are responsible for the formation of the blockages in these arteries are the cholesterol and triglycerides. The continuous supply of these two culprits through the food, I will not say culprit because basically cholesterol, triglyceride, both of these are very, very important for the functioning of our body. But after a certain amount, or after when it is the consumption is exceeded beyond limit, then the accumulation or the fat deposition and the blockages start to begin, and then begins the problems like angina, heart attack, cardiac arrest, myocardial infarction, heart failure, coronary thrombosis, angina, ischemia. All these are because of the these heart problems are due to the blockages. 98% the cause is the blockage, and the rest of the 2% it could be the hole in the heart or the wall dysfunction. Today my lecture will be, I'll be focusing on the blockage of the this cause of the heart ailments. Now, as I've already told you, the blockage is due to the fat deposition, the cholesterol and triglycerides. So what is cholesterol? Cholesterol is basically fat-like substance, which is very vital to the functioning of our system. And only the animals have the capacity to synthesize cholesterol. So all the animal foods, even we are also under the category of animal, and our liver also synthesizes the cholesterol. So, but beyond the certain amount, if the consumption is continued, then it is starts getting deposited in the arteries. So the cholesterol, if you want to limit, so you should limit the consumption of animal foods. Animal foods could be the red meat, the poultry, eggs, all the non-veg items. They are rich in cholesterol, and their consumption, as soon as if some person is suffering from the heart ailment, they should stop the consumption of all these animal products. And mind you, the animal products also include the milk products. So milk and milk products, the sources of cholesterol, like if you consume 100 grams of meat, you get 100 milligram of cholesterol. And the daily consumption of cholesterol needs to be restricted to only 10 milligrams. Yeah, 10 milligrams per day. So see how much exceedingly we are consuming this cholesterol through our food. One egg, if we consume, we get 240 milligrams of cholesterol. And if we consume the red meat and the liver and the brain, these have all the much more quantity of cholesterol in them. 100 milliliter of milk, of the buffalo milk, contains 20 milligram of cholesterol, and 100 ml of cow milk there's only 10 milligram of cholesterol, and 100 ml of toned milk we can have 5 milligram. And when we consume skimmed milk, 100 ml of skimmed milk, we get 1 to 2 milligram of the cholesterol. So the result, or the nutshell in which I'm trying to say, is the heart patient needs to consume only 200 ml of toned milk per day, and 500 ml skimmed milk is permissible. You make it cheese, you make it into curd, whatever form, but this is the quantity you need to consume per day, so that whatever the depositions, or the whatever the cholesterol is causing the deposition of the artery blockage, that will be reduced. And similarly, the triglycerides, the other culprit, the other factor which is responsible for the blockage in the arteries, is triglyceride. Triglycerides, no need to get confused. It is the scientific medical name for the fats and oils. There's a very minute difference between polyunsaturated. So you need not go in. I'm not going into details for into that. These marketing giants are, they have named certain oils that rich in these saturated oil, unsaturated, to confuse the public. The one thing only you need to understand is all fats, all oils are similar in chemical structure, with a very minute difference which won't make much of a difference, and if consumed inappropriately will play havoc with your heart health. This you need to understand. So you need to limit the triglycerides in your diet, because though they are necessary for our body, for the functioning of the body, we get them in the hidden form. There are foods which contain triglycerides in hidden form, like vegetables, nil. There's no fat in them, neither in fruits. But if you consume 100 grams of rice, you get 1 gram of triglyceride or fat. If you eat 100 grams of wheat or chapati, you get 1 gram of fat. And if you are consuming the pulses, the lentils, 100 grams, then you receive 5 grams of fat. And if raisins are consumed, a similar 100 gram, you get 0.3 gram of fats. In dates, you get 0.4 gram of fat. And mind you here, the people who are already suffering from heart problems, they need to restrict their intake of dry fruits. Dry fruits like the almonds, cashews, these are plant-based. As I've already told, plants do not have the capacity to synthesize cholesterol. So these dry fruits are cholesterol-free, but they have triglycerides, amount of fat is there. So people with the heart ailments need to consume very cautiously. Like I'll tell you, 100 grams of almonds will give you 58 grams of fat. Cashew nut, 50 grams of triglycerides. Coconut consumed, all these are 100 grams of the quantity I'm talking about. If you consume fresh coconut, 100 grams, you will receive 40 grams of fat. And the groundnut will give you 40 grams. Walnut, 64. Yeah, top of the list is walnut. If you're consuming 100 grams of walnut, you will get 64 grams. And the pistachio, which is which will give you 54 grams. So these are the foods you need to restrict if you're suffering from the heart ailments. And the normal layman, they need to consume in moderation, because the necessary triglycerides are there, which are required by the body for the functioning. Now, these are the two main culprits I talked about, but what are the factors which speed up the blockage? These are the two major factors which are responsible from outside food we are taking, and they, if they are taken in large amount, they are sticking to the arteries and forming the blockage. But what are the factors which will speed up their blockage? These are the factors: high blood pressure, when you are suffering from high BP, your arteries are spread beyond the capacity, beyond the their ability to hold the pressure. So the damage is already done on the walls, and it can speed up the formation of the blockage. Similarly, the high amount of sugar in your blood and alcohol consumption, smoking. What does smoking does? It forms a sticky layer on the walls of the arteries, which attract all the more of these greasy substances, and the blockage formation is becomes very fast. And obesity, of course, sedentary lifestyle. These are all the root causes, and various research papers all over the world have proved that the major cause of heart ailments are the blockages. So these are the factors which you should be keeping in mind, keep away. And what are the factors which are responsible for reducing the blockage? If you are suffering from heart ailment, and if you are not even suffering, but as a preventive measure, as a health promotion measure, you should be considering these following factors which I'm going to be talking about, is zero oil, plant-based wholesome food diet. Like, you need to inculcate more and more lots and lots of seasonal, fresh, local grown fruits and vegetables. Why fruits and vegetables in your diet? Because the two things the fruits contain is the fiber and the antioxidant. And what does the antioxidant does? It prevents the oxidation of the LDL, which is the low density lipoprotein, and it hampers the formation of the blockage. So your diet should consist of more and more of antioxidant, which will prevent the formation of blockages. And mind you, fruits and vegetables can lower the risk of your heart diseases by 20 to 30%. Yes, my dear friends. And another thing, 35 minutes of regular walk is mandatory for all the heart patients. But it varies from patient to patient. If the heart patient is suffering from knee problem, difficulty in walking, so accordingly they need to gradually and slowly increase their walking speed and duration, but they should start gradually, so according to their own bodily condition, considering all the parameters of your own health. But the target is to have that 35 minutes of physical activity which peps up your heart rate. But to what limit the heart rate needs to be pepped up, that is also to be considered very carefully. Till you become before you become that threshold level you achieve, you become breathless or palpitation, before that you need to stop. So the speed and the time has to be monitored according to your own bodily condition. But 35 minutes regular walk will keep your heart diseases away. Yeah, why? Because the walking will tone up your cardiac muscles, tone up your heart, and it will make your heart healthy. And also the HDL, the high density lipoprotein, is to be increased to help the prevention of the formation of blockages. And with walking and the right diet, the HDL will increase and the blockage will decrease. And other parameters, the health parameters, all needs to be kept under control by dietary modifications, by lifestyle modifications, by like you need to check your BP. It should be in the normal parameter, normal 120 by 80. It could be little up and down because everybody's normal is a little bit different. So don't panic and don't see your these gadgets. You know, like my BP is 100 by 60. It's the normal for me. So stick to your normal BP. Then the normal blood sugar level, the body weight should be kept under control. The nuts should be consumed in moderation. And there's also a very, people are very curious about the omega-3 fatty acid, omega-6 fatty acid. So my dear friend, there's not much difference. People, these all the marketing giants are playing with the minds of the common layman. We do not understand. So you do not fall into the in their trap. These are basically a very minute differences there. And in order to gain the omega-3 fatty acids, you need to consume a lot of the green, dark green vegetables like seaweed, broccoli, spinach, dark salad leaves, cabbage, and Brussels sprouts, the fenugreek leaves, black gram, cow pea, which is lobia, kidney beans, soya, all these food products. I will not recommend the fish liver oil because all the animal food I want you to exempt from because they have a cholesterol, which is not good for the heart patient. So, and along with these things, you also need to keep your cholesterol level below 130 milligram per deciliter. And the HDL should be 25% more than the cholesterol. You need to do regular yoga, pranayama, the breathing exercises, the meditation. And above all, no matter how good amount of diet or nutritious diet you eat, no matter how well you exercise, but the main culprit is the stress these days. You need to learn the techniques to master the stress on the daily basis, either by doing some meditation or you need to improve your behavioral skills. Like you need to understand, my dear friends, you cannot change the situations, the people around you, their behavior, but how you respond to them is in your hand. And that way you can manage a lot of stress and you can improve your health, your own heart health. So this is very much possible with little effort. And one more thing on my now before I end this session, there's a CT coronary scan to know the percentage of the blockage in your arteries. So whoever who are genetically predisposed and those who want to know what is the percentage of blockage in my arteries so that you can be cautious from right away before it becomes too much of the problem and it gets more than 90 or more than excess of blockage. So you need to control that. So for that, to know the percent of blockage in your arteries, go for the CT coronary scan. That way you will know the amount of blockage in your arteries and you can take action. And for even if you are not suffering from any heart ailments or whatever, all these tips for like consuming the starting your day with a lot of fruits and eating a lot of salad before each meal, consuming a lot of sprouts because they are rich in various nutrients and antioxidants. So not only they will help you keep your heart healthy, but they help you keep your sugar, your weight, your BP in check. And holistic health can be achieved only by following the right dietary modifications and doing the general yogasana pranayama and do not lead a very sedentary life. Go out in the open, enjoy the walk and the air bath, and daily dose of sunshine also, my dear friend, is very important for your health, for your heart health, and also overall health. So with these words, I think majorly I have covered everything. One thing while I go, I leave you. How do you know you have a heart problem? The basic check that one can do is, while you are sitting and doing normal work, there is no problem. See, until and unless the blockage is beyond 80% in the arteries, the person doesn't suffer any symptoms, because only 20% of the heart work is required for the supply of the blood to the entire system. So till then, there's no problem. But when we speed up in walking, when we carry the weight, and when we climb the stairs, if there is palpitation, breathlessness, or there is a pain in the left side of the chest and it radiates in the left arm. So my dear friend, this is the sign. These are the sign of early signs of the heart problem. So you need to be cautious right there. Sometimes also the sweating, the palpitations, also the tightness in the jaw and the right arm. Also there's pain which radiates all over the arm and the right shoulder. These are also the symptoms which will tell you, yeah, the arteries are blocked more than 80%. So you need to take the necessary action. And what is a heart attack? Heart attack means the blockage which is inside has been formed with the amount of whatever like fat consumption you are having that is sticking to your arteries and making the blockage. And this blockage is covered by a membrane. So when the blockage is continuous, it is not stopping, you are not taking control of your dietary fat, cholesterol, triglycerides, the accumulation and the blockages increase in size, and one day the outer membrane of the blockage, which is the intima layer, it gets burst. And when it gets burst, the chemicals from that flows into the blood and the blood clot is formed. And that is the time of 100% blockage of your arteries. The blood supply to the heart is stopped. And that is what is a heart attack. So what we need to do is, we need to stop the supply from the outside of all those things which are causing the blockage. And then when the supply is reduced, gradually the blockage will be reduced, and whenever the body requires the cholesterol, the triglycerides, the body will take the cholesterol already present in your body, and that way the blockage will be reduced, and gradually you will see, okay, you the people who were suffering, they were unable to walk a few miles, once their blockages start reducing, the disease starts reversing, they're able to walk so many kilometers, and their health drastically improves, their energy level improves drastically, and you yourself realize how quickly, after making the dietary, all the dietary modifications, your health is regained. So with these words, thank you, friends, and bye-bye.